Today I want to show you how we use a CMIzapper Medusa to read the ROM from a MacBook Air. This is an A1466, just a normal MacBook Air. It's the machine I use myself. It works just fine. Having a chipmunk USB tester plugged in helps us to know if the machine is actually switched off. This prevents us from messing about with the insides of a machine where we think it is off, but it's actually turned on, which would be kind of dangerous. Now that the machine is open and switched off, we can go and explore the SPI connector. It's this little guy here. Some people call it the JTAG connector, but since there's no JTAG signals on the connector, it's a bit silly to say that. I disconnect the battery connector. I've set the Medusa to fixed polarity, i.e. the easy flash mode. It comes with two easy flash adapters that are potentially going to fit in this machine. They have the same little connector on the back, and they're very similar but not identical. They behave different. One is yellow and one is red. Knowing which one is the right one is almost like black magic, because it depends on the model of the Mac, but it also depends on the firmware of the machine. So if the one doesn't want to work, try the other one, and at least one of the two should always work. You connect the Easy Flash adapter to the port A of the Medusa using that cable. I'm going to guess the red one today. The blinking means that there's communication going on. In this case, the Medusa is trying to detect a ROM chip. And the arrow on the Easy Flash adapter should point towards the hinge of the Mac in this particular model. So let's plug it in and see what happens. Nothing happens. The voltage is dropping a little bit, but not too much. But the machine is obviously not being powered. Let's connect it to a charger and see if that does the trick. Oh, it seems to be. The blue light comes on, the voltage is a lot happier, but it's still not seeing a chip. Let's try the yellow adapter. It's still not working, but the machine came on. We don't really want that. So let's unplug the MagSafe. Machine is off again. Let's reconnect MagSafe. Okay, now we got it. So it was the red one after all. The machine is connected to the charger, but it's switched off. The Medusa with all its switches down is in mode zero, which means it's going to show a lot of information about the ROM in the Mac. Let's see what it has to tell us. So it's seeing the ROM chip. It's telling us the model of the ROM chip. The QE bit of the ROM chip is set, which is appropriate for this model. It's seeing there's a lot of records set in the PRAM block. It's finding the FSIS block where the serial number lives. This is a serial number of the Mac. Mac is set to English, which is correct. The last Wi-Fi network it saw. With the button, you can step through serial number, production date. It's not locked. Firmware version, motherboard code, motherboard number, etc. To read the ROM, we have to put it into mode 1. So from switches 2 to 6, you're essentially putting in a binary number. So flipping this puts it into mode 1. It says read Mac ROM, and it will copy it into a ROM inside the Medusa. To do that, it has to erase the Medusa ROM first. It insists on erasing it so that in case anything goes wrong, and let's say you would read half of the ROM, you will never, ever, ever have a mix of two ROMs in the Medusa ROM. So it's forcing us to erase it. This takes a little while. If you're in a huge hurry, you could have erased the Medusa ROM beforehand, and then you would not have to wait for it now. Almost ready with the erasing. Now it's reading the Mac ROM into the Medusa ROM. On the left, it shows you how far it is. And on the right, it's showing the data that's passing. So you can see that's really something is happening. It is verifying everything while it is reading. So if anything goes wrong, it will know it goes wrong and it keeps on trying. So once you pass this reading, you know that what you read is actually correct. There's no need to read it three times and verify the files. The Medusa has already done that for you. Okay, ready. So now the ROM is in the Medusa. If you really want, we can see that by disconnecting the cable from the Mac, putting it back in the original mode zero, and we can plug it into itself. Yeah, this, the internal ROM of the Medusa is wired to port B, so we can have it examine itself. And you see it sees a wind bond chip. But this time, this is the chip that's in the Medusa, not the chip in the Mac. And we get all the same data. You see? Now that the data is on the ROM inside the Medusa, you could either use the Medusa to write it into a different Mac, the same way as we read it from this one. Or if you prefer, you could connect the Medusa to a normal programmer, like one of these, or the even more common, this one. Yeah, these cost nothing on AliExpress, and they work just fine. They're really primitive programmers, but because you're always communicating with the same ROM in the Medusa, to connect a Medusa to a PC, this is more than good enough. To connect it to the PC, you have to remove the USB from the Medusa. It will only act as a ROM. You connect the cable to port B, which is hiding under the screen. And the other end of the Medusa, you connect to this little guy. It comes with the Medusa. It has explanation on the back. Yeah, so I squared C with a notch going that way. So it plugs into the programmer like this. This should plug into the PC. You run the appropriate software and you can read and write to the Medusa ROM. So in this case, we have the data of this Mac in the Medusa ROM. So you would read it into your PC and maybe edit something if you want to edit it. And then you could write it back into the Medusa. And then using the Medusa, you could write it back into the Mac. You might wonder, why not just use this programmer to read the ROM directly from the Mac? But if you try that, you'll see that that doesn't really work. The ROM in the Mac, because it is in the Mac itself, yeah, there's more going on. The Mac might be accessing the ROM while you're trying to read it. The ROM and the Mac might not be powered properly. So there's a lot of problems and a lot of reasons why you cannot just read the ROM using a programmer, whereas with the Medusa you can. That's the whole magic of the Medusa. While we're at it, I'll give you a quick preview of a new tool that we're working on. That's this thing. Looks a bit like a Medusa, but it's different. Let's fire it up. This can communicate with the battery, so we can plug in the little adapter board for the MacBook Air battery. And this connects to the battery tool. And it gives us all sorts of information about the battery. It tells us the battery for MacBook Air 13-inch. Cycle count is 9. The capacity the battery still has, so it's a brand new battery. The name of the chip in the battery. The manufacture date of the battery. The battery is discharging. Yeah, which makes sense, we're not charging it. It's 17 degrees, it's winter here. The voltage on the battery. No current is going in or out the battery, which makes sense. The voltages on the two battery cells are nice and equal, so the battery pack is balanced. Permanent fail status, there's no permanent fail, firmware version, etc., etc. So this is a little tool that gives you a lot of information about the battery. We're still working on it, and more features are being added every day. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. Please subscribe to our channel and stay informed of all our new products. You can visit our website www.cmizapper.com.